Today, I'm going to show you how to film this thing right here, a TV, properly with a camera. Okay, you do not want any of these weirdo angles from any side, or up like this, or down like this, or maybe something like this, I don't know, but you do not want an angle like that. You want to get the camera as straight as possible, and to do that, you're going to need to set it on top of something. In my case here, I use a chair with a box sitting on top of it for my old Canon camera, and then I just stacked some game boxes on top of it that straight towards the TV, and then I was able to set up the camera as straight and as level to the TV as possible by simply tweaking how these sat on each other by the edges of them and stuff like that. It was very, very tedious to do, but I got it very, very straight. But nowadays, since I have a camera that likes to tip over like that, I have to use something else, and that is the Joby GorillaPod. This thingy right here. This thing is great for filming a TV if you want to, because you can bend these legs any which way that you want to, and that means that you can also tweak them really precisely when you angle a camera to the TV. I have, see the clip on top here? It's on the bottom of the camera right now. But when I want to put the camera onto this tripod, all you have to do is just slide it right on the clip like that, and then it just stays up like that. And so as you can see, this is still not very acceptable. So let's just see what we can do here. Let's just bend some stuff around here and lower the angle and stuff like that. And yes, this does take quite a while for me to set up between walkthrough parts, but this is something ideal. It's something like this, right in the center of the screen and level with the screen, okay? Now, what you want to do is zoom in on the screen so it cuts off all the sides of the screen. Not too much, but just enough so that it creates the illusion that you're looking at a square object. Like, I'm going to zoom in just I'm angled just a little bit too high, so I want to bring the angle down just a little bit, and then zoom in just a little more. Something like that. That's what you're looking for. Whatever you need to do to get this thing straight, level, and without it jiggling, do it. It doesn't really matter too much where you have to sit. Like, some people decide to put the cameras off to the side, so it's not in their way. But how is the camera getting in your way anyway? Because you just have to sit higher up than the camera, and then you can just look right over the camera, or you can sit off to the left or right side. It doesn't really matter, just as long as you get this camera straight to the TV. Now, the next thing that you want to do is, you see that window over there? You see that light? Shut it! Shut it, yes, shut it. All the lights in the room. See that window off to the left side over there? That's right, it's gotta be shut too. Well, at least the shades do. See the light in the room? That's right, all the light goes off in the room until you get something like this. Complete darkness. Actually, I can't see what I'm doing now. I don't care if you have Venetian blinds like this. If light shines through them, throw a blanket over them or out on the top or something just to keep the light out. Do whatever you can to get the room black. Where's the remote control? Oh, here we go. So then you want to just take a look at the TV here. I got some stuff set up here already. The game set up here. Okay, let's just like this. Here's Sonic Mega Collection. Oh, I got the camera angle absolutely perfect on my first shot. See that? Look at the top of the screen there. See how it's not cutting off too much of the screen, but I can go up just a little bit, and you can see that there's no screen up there. But as you can see, it's very straight on the TV. Well, maybe I could get it just a little bit better. Like, I'll tweak it, like, something. Maybe like this. What I love using, like, title screens like this, because it really gives you a good idea on what your angle should be and stuff like that. Like, you can see that I need to angle just a little bit down forward, something like that. And yeah, there's basically the straightness there. Now let's start up a game here. When you get to a game, you might notice that on some scenes, things will not look right. And I'm going to show you exactly why things don't look right. Very often, your camera has an auto white balance setting. And that auto white balance setting is not always correct. And so you have to make sure that that auto white balance setting stays to the correct colors on the TV. Now I'm going to show you what it looks like on a bad white balance setting. This looks kind of good right now, but just watch when I get to some gameplay here. I'm going to go to Angel Island Zone on my other completed save file here, and now just watch how the colors look on this. It looks like it's bluish green. Why does it look bluish green? That's because the camera is on the auto setting. The camera thinks that it's looking at tungsten lighting. Which is a more reddish tone of lighting, or orangish tone of lighting. So it compensates by creating a slight bluer atmosphere, which I don't want to say dilutes, which disperses that orange and balances out the correct colors. Now watch what happens when I switch to a better white balance setting. Alright, now this is much better right here. You can see that the green is now neon green like it's supposed to. The ground back there, I think it's supposed to be ground. Mountainside, whatever, is orange and yellow like it's supposed to be. The waterfall is nice and blue, and all I did to do this was change the white balance setting from auto, because it thought it was looking at tungsten lighting, to the daylight setting, which is whatever this TV is, I guess. You have to tweak your camera setting to find out what looks good to you, and that's really all there is to it. That it's not really hard to tweak the camera setting. Just go into the menus and stuff like that, or if it has like a dial or something on it, go right ahead and try out that, and you'll likely find the setting that will give you the colors that you need and stuff like that. That's really all there is to it. The stuff like if you have the black line on the screen, that usually has to do with a frame rate thing, like how many frames per second the camera's filming at. This camera films at around 60 frames per second, which technically is like 59.48 or something like that. Or I don't know the exact measurements, but it's equal to how fast the TV screen's frames per second is running at. So that will create no black line, or at least it does on this camera, because like I framed that 60 frames per second on other cameras before, but all it did was leave a static black line on the screen. So it seems to be like it varies from camera to camera. Sometimes you just have to deal with that line and put it at 30 frames per second and have like a really faint line going across the screen. There's just nothing you can do about it sometimes, just camera quality, so to speak. You just have to tweak the settings on your camera and find what works for you, as I said. So I guess that's it for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you later. Oh, also, one more thing. Always make sure that the volume on the TV set is up pretty high, so the camera can pick it up as well as your voice. I would put it at like 20 to balance out my voice from the game sounds. At least in this case, it varies from game to game depending on how loud or quiet each game is. Ouch. So you want it to get it about exactly the same volume as your voice. If not a little bit less than your voice, but it's a personal preference thing. Sometimes what you think isn't what actually is best for the video. But when you play around with the camera, do a load of tests and stuff like that, you'll get the hang of it. Alright, see you later.